Welcome to Gaga Knits. My name's Anita and I live in South Wales in the UK. I hope you've all had a nice weekend. Did you watch the wedding? Of course, it was the royal wedding with Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. And didn't they have a lovely day? Wonderful weather. And us Brits know how to put on the pomp and ceremony, don't we? We don't fail on that score. I'm sorry the vlog is a little late this week. We've had a visitor over from Ireland. My son Josh met up with Sinead and Niamh on his travels in Australia and New Zealand, and Sinead came over to visit him this weekend. So I've been busy cleaning the house and making a meal and things so that she could feel settled in. They've gone now off to Tenby and various places so that she can see a little bit of Wales as she's not visited before. We've been having some lovely weather in Wales and the rest of the UK for the last few days, absolutely glorious. And we took Charlie for a lovely walk this morning that I'm going to put in Walkies with Charlie. The bluebells were out and it was just absolutely beautiful. There's a little bit of film footage, hopefully it will look nice, and some photographs as well as usual. In June, I'm going to be going back to work full-time hours. I'll still be having Wednesday afternoon off to pick Harry up from school, but I will be making those hours up by working longer hours on the other days. Although this is better for my bank balance, it's not good for my crafty life because I won't have so much time to get on with crafts. So I'm not going to do a regular fortnightly vlog anymore. I've had to think about it, the best way to do this. And I think rather than give an actual date or you say once a month or anything like that, I'm going to just vlog as and when I've got a finished object. And then when I show you that, obviously I'll have other things, works in progress and things on the go as well. So it's just going to be on an ad hoc basis so that I don't feel pressured that I have to do things or make things when I don't feel like it, because obviously my time is going to be more limited. So if you like watching my vlogs, please subscribe and then you'll be notified of when my next vlog is up, as like I say, they're not going to be on such a regular basis anymore. I've scribbled some notes down quickly because I've been so busy and I'm just having a little glance. Right, that was all that. They were the only things I really needed to tell you about. So let's get on with knitting. The last few weeks I haven't really done very much again, so it's a little bit disappointed, but I have been working on my Spanglish socks. I have a Ho, I finished one and here it is, and that yarn is Sherlocked by Owl About Yarn, and the pattern is also by Owl About Yarn, the Spanglish socks, and I've been test knitting these for her, and like I say, I think I'm the very last person to finish. She did give us till the end of May, but I know she wants to release the pattern at the end of May, so I am a bit late, but I've been knitting and knitting away, and I'm this far on the second sock and I've turned the heel and I'm going down to the toe, so it's pretty much the pattern rows and going round and round, so I'm hoping to finish these. Well, I want to finish them for next weekend because they're for my son-in-law Matthew and he wants to take them camping, and we're all going camping next weekend, Tenby, so he wants them finished for that, and Jenny wants them finished for the test knit, but I'm getting there, Jenny. I promise I won't be long. I haven't made any progress on my Love's Promise cardigan because I've been working so hard on my socks and I haven't had much time to craft these last 2 weeks. So it's a little bit unfortunate, but never mind. So that's all I've got for knitting this time. Sewing. As you can see, I have my dresses here. I have been making the new look K6262. I did this one here, which is View A. And I made this one a while ago, and I do have an apology to this pattern. I complained that the sizing was all out and it didn't fit, it was far too big, and I was determined to keep practicing on the same pattern until I got my sizing right, rather than cracking on with other projects. And so when I did this one, I was looking at the pattern pieces that I used originally. I traced them off, and I don't know what I did, because the bodice was one size and then the skirt was totally way off. So it wasn't the pattern's fault. For some reason, I just don't know what I was doing, but it went completely wrong. So this one here, I used the size 12 and it fits me really nicely. I forgot to take the bodice up an inch because I'm only 5'1½. I think I would benefit from the bodice being up an inch. But it fits me nicely, but the next one I'm going to make, I'm going to take the bodice up an inch, and then I think it'll give me a nicer fit. So I'm going to insert a little video of me wearing the first New Look K6262 that I made in the Line of Hearts fabric there. So this one, with the adjustments, all I did, I was a little bit lazy, I just undid the side seams and graded it in a little bit, cut that, sewed it again. So it isn't the best of jobs, but I will wear it, but I'll probably just wear it around the house and things like that, so that doesn't matter. And then the other one, all I've got to do is sew the hem. I've been working on it today. I was trying to get it finished with this, but it was either do the vlog or sew the hem. So the vlog went over and the hem will be sewn either tonight or Wednesday when I'm off next. Oh, and let me see, the fabric is called Haberdashery and I had it from Fabrics Galore. The pattern is a nice pattern if you're a new sewer to get into sewing dresses, and the Stitch Sisters this week did a vlog on inserting invisible zips, and although I've done a couple, it was really nice to see them sew it up. So when it was just before I put the zip in my haberdashery dress. So I was really pleased with that, because then I felt more confident sewing the zip in. So that worked well. The only thing is the back waistline is a little bit off, because I got so enthusiastic about sewing the zip in, I forgot that I'm supposed to line up the waistline. It's about that much out. Get it done. It's there, it's only a tiny bit out, but never mind. So I'm happy with that, and once the hem is sewn, I'm going to wear it, because it's lovely weather as well, and I'm looking forward to actually wearing a dress that I've made myself that actually fits. In the pipeline for sewing, I have a little announcement to make. My daughter Jodie is expecting her second baby. So exciting. They didn't want anyone to know until they'd had their first scan. So they've had the scan and everything's fine. And now I have a lady in work that's expecting a baby. Hers is due in October. Jodie's expecting it at the end of November, and so is one of her good friends. And I just found out today that my son of my next door neighbours is expecting a baby with his girlfriend as well. So lots and lots of babies are going to be arriving towards the end of this year. So my in the pipeline is this pattern, which is the Birder 6956. And my daughter wants me, oh, my camera's the other way around, wants me to make this version. Obviously, I don't like the fabric they've chosen on there. And she doesn't want, well, she likes sleeves because she likes to cover the top of her arms, but she doesn't mind having those sleeves. But I suggested flutter sleeves because I see a lot of people with that sleeve at the option at the moment, which is quite nice. So I'm going to have a little go at pattern hacking. I've got this book here called So Many Dresses, So Little Time, and it's by Tanya Whelan. And in here somewhere, I've put Matthew's foot in there to hold my page. They show you how to make, oh, I hope it's not shining, bell sleeves. They're calling it bell sleeves, but that's the same as the flutter sleeve. How to convert your pattern to make bow sleeves. So I'm going to have a go at doing that for her with the bird pattern. And the fabric I've chosen is this jersey fabric. I don't know if you can see. I can't see me, so I'm hoping you can see. And I know I'm on a budget and I'm not supposed to be buying fabric, but I bought this fabric just before I told you I was going on a budget because I knew she was expecting and I wanted to get some fabrics that she'd like. She's got red hair, so the green, the minty green in the back is always a good colour for redheads. Can't remember where I got this from. I did have a quick look around to see if I could find the invoice so that because I do like to tell you where I get things from, but I couldn't find it. So if I do, by the time I edit this, I'll just write it on the screen. I know I've got it. I'm sure I'll find it somewhere. So that's my next project when I've sewn the hem on my haberdashery dress. Acquisitions. I've sort of lumped them together. I haven't bought anything. A little while ago, Harriet from Harriet's House, Harriet's House podcast, did a hat along, and I entered my hat that I test knitted for Elliot Tithe and Bryn, the sweetheart hat. And then I forgot all about it because it was quite a while ago. And Harriet contacted me to say I'd won a prize, so that was wonderful. And this is what I won. She made a little needle cosy with, if you can see, Harriet's House, the little lovely little wooden, her name, a little wooden plaque. And she's made this. It's beautiful, really well made. And also, she sent me some, oh, 2 millimeter higher sharps. 2 millimeter are the thinnest, finest needles I've ever had, so I don't quite know what to make with those. If you have any suggestions of things that you can knit up with very fine needles, please let me know and I shall look the patterns up. And also, because in work they know I like to sew and knit things, one of my friends very kindly gave me this book, Cute and Easy Costumes for Kids. Now she said her children are quite grown up, they're teenagers now, that she bought this book when they were little with the aim to make them fancy dress outfits and things like that. And she never did. So she said it's just going to waste and collecting dust. And she thought I might like it. And it's really lovely book. And it's by Emma Hardy. And it's in sections. There's animals and insects, adventurers, fairy tales and nursery rhymes, costume classics and Halloween. Now, the lady who's expecting a baby in work has already asked me, will I make that for her little baby? Because her baby's due in October. And I think it'll be too small for this, the first Halloween, but for the baby's second Halloween, she wants he or she to be dressed in that dinosaur outfit. And this one made me laugh when I saw it. No sewing involved. Because it reminded me of the story I told you last time, where, well, I'm not sure if it was last time, but one of the vlogs gone, that when I made Jodie dress up as Hickory Dickory Dock and she was in a cardboard box and couldn't sit down when she went to the disco. So I should make the robot for Harry And then he could go to a school disco and not be able to sit down, and I've started a little trend. So I feel like I've rushed through things a little bit this time. So I feel like I've rushed through things a little bit this time. I haven't done much. And that's one of the reasons why when I go return to work full time in June, I'm not going to do fortnightly vlogs, like I say. So please subscribe if you do want to see more of more of what I get up to, because they're just going to be very ad hoc, and then there's no pressure on me, and I still enjoy filming them then. So all I've got left is walkies with Charlie. Like I say, it's a walk we took this morning. It's quite near the house. It's up some very narrow lanes, which were a bit scary because there were no pull-in places if something was coming the other way, but it was well worth it. It's a forestry walk, and like I say, it was absolutely beautiful, and it was very near a walk we usually take, and I had no idea it was there. Josh told us about it because he likes to go off-road cycling. He knows lots of different places around here that I know nothing about. So I hope you enjoy Walkies with Charlie, and all take care, and I shall see you all again soon. Bye.